The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
The need for localized economic manufacturing, and that's a theme that's kind of growing and becoming much stronger in the last few months. There's other opportunities as well to work with other customers that we've been targeting. And so we're hopeful that we've moved the ball down the field, so to speak, and this is a really good positive step forward.
Welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom. Joining me now from Nano One Materials Corp is the Chief Operating Officer, Alex Holmes. And Alex, it's great to see you again. How are you?
I'm well, thanks, Steve. Great to see you again as well.
So really big news out from the company that we'll talk about in just a second. All has to do with the partnership that you have with Sumitomo Metal Mining. And let's sort of take a step back here and just remind everyone, this partnership has been going on for a couple of years now.
Yeah, no, let's reframe that. So September 2023, we struck a partnership, really a strategic collaboration with Sumitomo. At that time, they invested in Nano One about $17 million, just under 5% of the company, really with the objective of working together on the technology with the end goal of commercializing our technology. And so we've come a long way in 2 years.
Yeah. And so they, in essence, have been doing a lot of testing, a lot of things that, that they need to do on their side in order to have due diligence, which is very important. And now the news out is they've released that, yes, they think this is something that could be used by them and others as well. This is very positive news.
Yeah, we, there's been many activities, as you say, from product development, trials in Japan, working with them to, meet their customer specs, plant economics, and also strategies. And, if I think back to when we first set out this collaboration, the goal was to commercialize, right, and bring our cost competitive patented technology to market with them. And at the start, it was really focused on, Sumitomo being able to serve the Japanese ecosystem and ultimately the North American ecosystem for Japanese automotives, because not many people may know this, but the U.S. market is the largest market globally for the Japanese automotives. And so they really wanted to play a big role in supporting their existing customers to getting there. And I think because of the relationship and because of the need for localized economic manufacturing, and that's a theme that's kind of growing and becoming much stronger in the last few months, there's other opportunities as well to work with other customers that we've been targeting. And so we're hopeful that we've moved the ball down the field, so to speak, and this is a really good positive step forward.
Alex, really at the end of the day, what they mentioned in the news release is basically that the process, the one-pot process for them works, but it also saves money. It saves on energy consumption, wastewater generation, everything that you and Dan Blundell, your CEO, have been talking about over the years about why you're doing this to begin with. They seem to really verify that.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think starting with recognizing Sumitomo is the most vertically integrated miner, refiner, cathode active materials maker today. They supply tier one cell maker. Panasonic is a huge customer of theirs. Downstream of that, automotives, of course. So they bring deep knowledge and know-how in the space. Mm-hmm. And they recognize that copying, really what is the process that's largely done in China and copying that outside of China, it's just simply not economic. And the customers want competitive costs, and they also want differentiation. And, the path to permitting cleaner technologies is also something that, that the customer would like to see integrated into the supply chain.
Yeah. So now that you have this, in your back pocket, so to speak, how does this relationship evolve now, and what's sort of the next stages here?
Well, we see this really as a starting point now to engage in customer conversations, our target customers, both Sumitomo's, but also some of the ones we've been speaking to. As I mentioned, the theme of economic localization has only grown stronger in the last few months. And so we see this is where the partnership's going, and we'll start those activities. Some of them have started, we'll continue those activities. On the latest trip to Japan, I was just there in August as part of a Canadian trade mission. We met with senior government officials there in Sumitomo. This was an opportunity for Sumitomo to understand kind of how Canada looks at the battery supply chain, the importance of the midstream, I should say, and really what they're looking to help support and build in Canada. And it goes so much farther than Canada, really. If we think about the G7 nations and trying to strengthen economies and national security, increased spending in energy storage systems, defense applications, et cetera. So really, you know, the world is opening up for nano. So it's really, you know, we're really pleased to see that things are aligning.
Absolutely. I know that you're continuing to put money into the company and trying to help move everything forward, as you as obviously have stated in the past, with investment from a number of different areas. You're also using at the market as well. Maybe explain that so everyone understands what that is.
Yeah, so I think it's a great opportunity, actually, maybe to clarify, Steve, because we've had a few shareholders looking for information on trying to understand what an ATM is. It's an at the market offering. So essentially what it is it allows us, it's a very kind of normal course, pragmatic tool to use these days, allows the company to issue some shares into the trading volume of the market with very low fees, right? So it's very low commissions. It provides us that flexibility. So we just have to think of it as another tool. You know, I think one of the key considerations is ATMs typically trade maybe 5 to 10% of volume. And this is not us working with the agents to have them have carte blanche to freely sell shares. So management's in complete control of what gets sold and when. And, you know, we're trying to be mindful of not impacting the market. It's very typical for a market post ATM announcement to respond kind of in the way it has. But I think, you know, our longstanding shareholders stand beside us. They remain supportive. They're strengthening. And, you know, if we look at today's reaction to the news, I think that's a pretty good indication of what we've been able to achieve.
Absolutely. So just wrapping up here, Alex, exciting days ahead, sounds like.
Yes, busy and exciting.
Yeah, good stuff. Thanks very much. Good to see you again. And we'll look forward to our next conversation, okay?
Very good. Thank you, Steve. Take care.
All right. Alex Holmes, the Chief Operating Officer for Nano One Materials Corp.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.